श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्किक केसरी वेदांताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्ता सदा हृदय नमो नारायण। हियर स्वामी देशिकन ही मेंशन्स इन दिस श्लोकम नंबर 14 ही हैज टेकन अप दैट दोस who contemplate on Swami Hayagrivan and perform dhyanam with ananya prayojana, only the mere enjoyment of Hayagrivan at all times, for them the thoughts on the fruits of meditating upon the sacred form of Lord Hayagrivan, how the other purusharthams, the anushangikamaga other purusharthams would come on their own, similar to Kulasekara Azhvar Pasuram, ninnaye than vendi neel selvam vendadan tannaye than vendum selvam pol. So those who are focused and contemplate only on Hayagrivan with no other thoughts, no other desires, no other fruits other than enjoyment of him, for them on its own accord sarva sakala kala, the learning, the jnanam would come on their own. That's the benefit of Hayagriva's grace conferred on bhaktas. He is thus bound to shine as an orator, a speaker, creator of literature, master poet, excellent artist in any field of the divine, and the whoever is privileged to cherish the Lord in his heart, contemplate on him. Hayagrivan blesses us for him as he embarks in his day-to-day life. The words, the ideas would come on their own, the right words at the right time, appropriately. And that's what is mentioned in this sloka 14. Manogatam pasyati yassa dhatvam manishinam manasa rajahamsam स्वयं पुरो भाव विवाद बाजह किं कुर्वते तस्य गिरो यतार्हम् मानस राजहंसम्। देर इज इन द हिमालयास माउंटेन देर इज अ सरस, ए पॉन्ड कॉल्ड मानस सरस। इट्स प्योर, प्रिस्टाइनली प्योर, क्लियर वाटर, सेक्रेड। इन दैट देर आर रॉयल स्वैम्स विच स्विम and blissfully enjoy. Here Swami mentions that manasa rajahamsam, the mind, if you consider that as the manasa saras, the pond in which the rajahamsam, the in that pond blissfully seated and enjoy swimming in that pond of the bhaktals is you, Hayagriva, Thwam, Unnai, such you who is swimming blissfully in the Manasa Saras, the mind of the Bhagavatottamas, Jnanis, Veda Vedantic scholars. In that you, Manishina Yaha, in among those who contemplate you in their mind, sada manogatam pasyati, at all times in their mind, if they contemplate you as the royal swan in their heart cavity, and keeping, if they see you, means if they keep you in their minds and perceive you or have the vision of yours, tasya, for them, Giraha, the vak, the words, the statements, and the vak, Purobhavaha, Vivada Bhajaha, Purobhava Vivada Bhajaha. They compete with each other, the words, and would come as if they come at the right time, at the appropriate moment, competing with each other. So the effect is similar to the falling of the merciful Dhyai Kataksham of Mahalakshmi on a Jivatma. When those auspicious glances fall on one from Mahalakshmi, the various categories of wealth chase each other to be in the front row or bless the Jivatma. Yasyam yasyam disi viharate devi drishtistvadiya tasyam tasyam ahamahamikam tanvate sampadogaha. Sri Stuti, 15th verse. So here Purobhava Vivada Bhajaha, they compete with each other, words compete with each other and the walk and come to those bhaktas. Yadarham kinkurvate, so that they perform kaikaryam to that bhaktan of Hayagriva. And so here it mentions that for those who are performing ananya prayojana dhyanam, all these purushartams would come on their own as anushankikam, on their own accord. They don't have to desire, seek and pray. It comes and they don't care even if they don't. So sharir arogyam artascha bhogaschaiva anushangikan dadati dhyayinam nityam apavarga prato harihi. So Shastram says, Bhagavan grants the bhaktas who perform dhyanam on him as the only means and the goal, nothing else. He himself is the means, he himself is the goal, no other desire. For them, Bhagavan gives all the bhogams, all the worldly pleasures and the wealth, anushankikam, on his own, automatically, says Shastra. So, also, Sri Vasudevachar writes the commentary that abhilashita durabha ye pura kama bhogaha jalatimiva jalaukaste vishanti swayam naha. When I was seeking the worldly pleasures and the material pursuits, they were evading me. They were not coming to me and I could not get and I felt frustrated. Now with Acharya Sadacharya Kataksham, with his grace, now I am, because of Bhagavat Kataksham, I do not seek them and I have jukupsai on that. I have dislike on those bhogams and now somehow I get involved in Bhagavad Anubhava Pravritti. And because of that, when I get immersed in Bhagavad Anubhavam, all those bhogams automatically come to you like the rivers come to the ocean, come to me, says this particular line. So similarly, here, for those who meditate on Hayagrivan, Swami Desigan says, those yogis who have the power to visualize the Raja Hamsam, the Lord Hayagrivan, seated on a white lotus in their heart cavity, heart lotus, they are blessed with the Siddhi, the fruits of full command of divine speech, vak. The various vidyas in the form of words rush to them saying, please make use of me, please make use of me, in a competitive manner. They argue as it were with one another to serve the upasakas, the devotees, who visualize pashyanti, the Raja Hamsam, Hayagrivan, seated in their heart. Manogatam manasa Raja Hamsam pashyanti. These blessed ones perform and these blessed ones are the objects of Kaikariyam for all Vidya, and as a result, they become the exponent of great Vidya. And Swami Desikan is a prime example of the blessed one, whom the Vidyas, all the arts, served competing with one another due to Bhagavan Hayagrivan's Paramanugraham. So he said, Devam Hayagrivam Aham Prapadye. And all this came Anushankikam automatically to Swami Desikan. That's what is mentioned in this verse. So in this previous slokam, Swami Desikan began to focus on the power of Sri Hayagrivan to confer the boon of Vedavak. In the subsequent slokams, Swami focuses on the Dhyana Anubhava Janita Sukham and blessings granted by Lord Hayagrivan. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Namo Narayana. Adiyan.